y'all. So today we're going to go over the highly anticipated Glorious Masquerade event. I feel like everyone's been waiting for this, and it's finally here. I absolutely loved this event when it happened over on JP, and I'm so happy Ian is finally getting it. So without further ado, everybody grab your masks, and let's talk. So let's start off with a brief overview. I'm sure for most people this isn't your first Halloween event, but if it is, Halloween is a huge, huge deal in-game. The event story is 5 books long, and in order to unlock things, you'll need to do lessons. You aren't earning any item for unlocking, it's just like, do 20 lessons with someone from Heart's Lobule to unlock things. So make sure you read the unlock conditions before doing lessons. It's the worst when you do lessons and then go to the event map to read something, only to find out you did the wrong thing. We have Masquerade Masks as our event item, which are used in the event shop, and Masquerade Costumes, which are used for grooving the event participation cards. As per usual of Halloween events, we have 11 new cards joining the roster. If you would like a full analysis and breakdown of each card, I have a video for that. Link will be in the iCard and in the description. So by reading the event, you can gain a total of 5 characters. First is Rare Ruggie, then Rare Riddle, Rare Rook, Rare Silver, and finally SR Deuce. Unlike other event cards, they're built normally except for their groovy item, which is the little masquerade costume. The rares will need 1 to be groovied and the SR will need 3, but everything else is fine. You don't need a farm for things to raise their magic levels. That's some foreshadowing. We'll come back to that, actually. And also, I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but these cards do not have vignettes. It absolutely sucks and I hate it, but yeah, they don't have stories with them. The gacha cards, however, do have vignettes, so there's that at least, but yeah. So in the gacha, we have 6 cards, and as per usual with Halloween events, although they all drop at the same time, only 2 have rate up at a time. If their picture is on the banner, they have rate up. If their picture is not on the banner, they do not have any rate up. If I see someone complaining on Twitter about this again, I'm going to be mad. Yes, all the Halloween cards are new. No, that doesn't mean that they all have rate up. Only 2 have rate up at a time. And because only 2 have rate up at a time, I really recommend waiting until a specific banner to pull. Yes, if you pull on Azul's banner, you theoretically could get Malleus or Idia. However, you are most likely going to waste so many gems doing this. I know waiting sucks, but please wait. Please be patient. Our banners are SR Apple and SSR Azul, SR Sebek and SSR Idia, and SR Jameel and SSR Malleus. Like past Halloweens, these banners will run twice. We get them one after the other, and then for the second run, they all run simultaneously. Okay, so I'm going to be fully honest in a bit. I have no idea if I have all the furniture for this event and how many pieces there actually are. Like, I felt I got everything when the event ended, and then as I built cards months and months later, new DIY recipes just started popping up in my crafting menu. I would love to be methodical and fully on point for this section, but like, yeah, I'm honestly not really sure what's going on with some of these recipes. And I hate to bring even more bad news, but like, remember how I said foreshadowing? This event has not just event paint, but also event-specific building items that you'll need to build things. So, you're not farming for, you know, event items, you're building for guest room stuff. It's awful and I hate it. And I don't know if this makes it worse or better, but some items don't need the event paint or event building items to be made. It's just, it's all over the place, and I really hope for part 2 that, like, make it uniform or something, because, like, what? Why? What was the point of this? So, let's start with items that do not need event-specific items, because this list is a lot shorter. You can make these whenever you want, there's no expiration date on them, which is nice. It's still weird, though, but anyway. We've got Ruggie's Masquerade Costume, Riddle's Masquerade Costume, Rook's Masquerade Costume, Silver's Masquerade Costume, Deuce's Masquerade Costume, and the Glorious Masquerade Frame. I don't remember if the costumes all dropped at once or if it was like gradual. I do know there's some prerequisite to getting the Glorious Masquerade Frame because it just showed up randomly in my recipes one day in like February? It was well past the event and I was confused, so yeah, that's a thing. I would guess you would have to max out event levels or groovy all the event participation cards for that, but I'm honestly not sure. I had no idea this existed until I saw it. And now we have furniture that needs event-specific items and has an expiration date on when to make it. We have the Crimson Flower Partition, Sebek's Masquerade Costume, Apple's Masquerade Costume, Jameel's Masquerade Costume, Malleus's Masquerade Costume, Idia's Masquerade Costume, Azul's Masquerade Costume, Rolo's Uniform, Noble Bell College Diorama, Gargoyle Plushies, the Cringe Judge Frollo Statue, it's not actually called that, I'm calling it that because I don't like Frollo, Noble Bell College Candles, Noble Bell College fireplace, Bell Tower flooring, Noble Bell College foyer flooring, Bell Tower wallpaper, Noble Bell College foyer wallpaper, Chandelier 1 and Chandelier 2. Some of those names are just descriptors by me and not the real names. We have a lot of ground to cover, and not gonna lie, I'm just too lazy to open G-Show right now. Luckily, I screenshotted the recipes when they dropped, so I can tell you how many of each item you'll need for building. Assuming you're making only one of all of these, at least, you will need 200 event paint, 252 event metal, 124 event lumber, 140 event crystals, 193 event cloth, 70 event clay, and 101 dalmatians, I mean event stones. It's a lot of resources, I'm not gonna lie. This event, at least for JP, did last a while, but still, I would really recommend to stay on top of farming, and honestly, maybe even save gauntlet AP refills for this event. I'm assuming it's possible to farm all of this within the event. I didn't, but, you really, really need to stay on top of it, and I would recommend keeping maybe, like, a little notebook or, like, something where you can write down how many of each event items you have and keep track of it via that, just so you know, like, okay, I've earned all of the event paint, now I can move on to something else. You're just gonna have to be very on top of the guest room stuff if you all want it. If you don't want the guest room stuff, then you're fine, like, you can just ignore all of this, but, like, if you want all of it, you're really going to have to stay on top of this, and I... Oof. Just oof. My final note is, even if you have the gacha units, the recipes for their costumes is still time limited. I have all the SRs and SSR Malleus, and I can't make their costumes anymore. I don't care for that, to be honest, but just as a heads up, getting that gacha card does not guarantee you get the recipe forever when it comes to gacha units. Although I will say it is nice you can make costumes for units you don't have. I think that should cover everything. I love this event, and I cannot stress just how excited I am for this for EN. And with that, good luck on the banners, guys, especially good luck farming for stuff for the guest room, and I will see you guys later. Once again, thank you everyone for watching my videos. If you would like to support me beyond liking and subscribing and all of that, I have a Patreon, and I also have channel memberships. If you like live streaming, I live stream over on Twitch every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. But yeah, thank you guys for watching my videos, and I hope they help you. Bye! Shameless plug over.